Hello and welcome to the first lesson of my Richard Burns Rally School. Today we are going to look at the Chirdonhead stage from Britain. First I'm going to tell about this stage, then drive it slowly through while telling you the lines, breaking points, and at the end we will look a replay from a race speed run. Chirdonhead is the stage that I can remember from the times when I tried Richard Burns Rally very first time, and since that it has always been one of my favorite stages for both testing and racing. So it felt a good way to start this video on this stage. It is a full gravel stage with nice grip. Overall it's smooth, but there are some little holes and few ruts. There is also few jumps, but nothing special. The nature of the stage is not really simple. At the beginning there is two tight corners followed by long and fast corners that leads to the left junction. Then begins the most flowy section with some short and fast corners where you can dance with the car. That section opens to a really fast corners which ends up again to some tighter corners. Next, there is a little bump straight and really difficult braking after that, and a few corners later we have the second junction. The section between that second and the upcoming third junction is really fast, including one tighter and one extremely long corner. On the last part before the finish there is still a bit of everything, so for sure you can't get a perfect flow here. That was the introducing, and let's now go to the stage. And here we are, at the beginning of the stage. I'm not going to record this many times, so my language will not be perfect, but for me it's more important to do more videos than to only one video per year with good English. So it is what it is. At the beginning we have a left, right, left, all flat out, really slight corners. Only thing to look is a little bit your line, so you go as straight as possible. So let's go. Left line here, then to the right, and quite early to the left. Exit this slight left to the right side of the road, and here you can see that, let's go a little bit back. You can see that the black thing is a little bit darker area. There is a little like hole, and you can use that as a, how to say it, reference point for your braking point, because there is nothing else. So if it's okay for you, you can think that you brake immediately after it, or top of it, or before it. It depends a bit of the driver and the car and the setup. For me, with R5 car, it is just after that. And it's not that a big hole that it would upset your car or break your braking grip. It's only for a, like a reference point for a braking point. So you are here on the right side of the road, as right as you can without touching that bank outside of the corner, and you want to go quite early in on that left corner. And let's first talk about the gears. So with R5 cars it's a fourth gear. Sometimes if you really have a good setup and good feeling and you like to drive with the torque, you can do it with fifth gear, but I would say that the fourth gear is generally better, and a WRC car is fourth or fifth gear, maybe fourth. So you turn quite early in, you can go a little bit sideways here at the beginning of the corner, and you can cut a little bit, but don't do too much because there are that little push here and some sticks, and also the grass itself is like little bit sticky here, so it will suck the car and it will spin quite easily, or at least you cannot turn to, you cannot turn as early as you should to the next corner if you hit too much on this grass here. Somewhere at this point you keep in and then quite early turn into the next corner, and as you see we have now here inside of that left corner, at the exit of this left corner, a positive road camber. But for the next corner, the next right corner, it is a negative road camber. So we have to like climb up from the negative road camber to the positive road camber, and the car will not jump, but light, it go a little bit light when going, you know, over that camber change. And when the car is light, there are no loads on the tires and it's impossible to turn. So be sure that you turn in before you go over that road camber change. Okay, so somewhere here, oh, I'm not really good with that new clutch pedal. So somewhere here turn in and be sure that your car is pointing on right direction before it lightens when you go over that camber change. You don't have to brake anymore. If you are not confident or if you don't have a good setup, you can do a little bit left foot braking, and you while doing that left foot braking, it also reduces the lightening when going over that camber change. Don't cut here, there's a rocks inside, and there is also a little bit like a positive road camber inside of this right corner. So you kind of jump on the positive road camber on that left corner to the positive road camber of this right corner. You can exit this corner quite here, like quite wide, which allows you to go in with higher speed. But go off really soon, because there is that bush, and especially this little tree. This is really solid and will break your car. Then we have a really long left corner, flat out. Again, we have a positive road camber here inside of the corner and negative outside of the corner, so keep in on this corner. You can cut a bit, a little bit like tire width, and don't go sideways with your car, because then your rear tires will hit on those negative road camber, which is outside this corner, and it will make the driving difficult and you will lose time. Keep in here on the exit. Not again. Keep in here with the exit and quite early go in with this right, which is also flat out, and same camper things here also. And here we have rock. It's quite easy to turn too much and hit on this rock, so be careful with that. It opens a little bit, and then go, we have a quite slight right over the crest, and like the little hole on the first breaking point, this crest is something like a reference point for breaking point. Sometimes some driver with some car or some setups want to brake, especially if the grip is wet and slippery, even before this crest. It's quite safe usually to brake on the top of this crest, and if you are pushing and you have a good setup and slow car, or relatively slow car like R5, you can brake after the crest. Be in on the right side of the road here. You can tilt the line here on the grass a little bit. Watch out those, I don't know what they are, stumps, maybe tree stumps. There was one, I can reverse a little bit. You can see maybe now. There's a little stump, watch out it. And there is this little bus. It sometimes it breaks your windscreen, but if you really want to do a good time, it's maybe worth of it. Then we have I have a lot of to tell on this junction. We have a junction left, and I want to go quite early in, but I want to go in with the really sideways. And now I'm really doing my best to tell you why I want to be a really sideways. I want that when I'm sliding, you can cut a little bit When I'm sliding here, the car is somehow on this position, really sideways, already. I set the car on this position when I go into the corner. So now when I'm sideways, sliding on top of the grass, I don't floor the throttle. I push a little bit the throttle, so the tires will pull the car to the left where the road is going after the junction. But I won't push the throttle so much that I got wheel spin, cause that will make my car just slide too much and I will go off the road at the exit of the corner. So just a little bit throttle while you are sliding over the crest. Over the crest. And when you are here, back on the gravel, you can floor the throttle. Not maybe immediately, because there is a... I go back a little bit. You can see there is a hole. There is two holes. One on the right and bigger one on the left. And those will break your grip a little bit. And also, if you are sliding here, you have a little bit negative road camber, which will make the exit of the corner quite slippy. So be careful. Sometimes you can floor the throttle when you hit the gravel, and sometimes you have to wait a little bit. But still keep a little bit of throttle so the tires will keep pulling you out of the corner. Then begins the flowly section, I would say the best section of the stage. This is just a long right corner, nothing special. Cut a little bit, like keep your front right tire on the ditch. Go off somewhere here, not off the road, off the ditch. And there's a little slight right-hander and keep in here on the right side of the road. And now we are coming to the crest. And again, you want to turn in just before the car jumps, just before you lose the load of the tires, just before the car goes lighter. But don't go too right, because then you will, your tire will dip into the ditch and it will be difficult to turn in for that left corner. You get the load back somewhere here, where the car lands, and be sure not to cut on those. I don't know what they are, signs or something like that. They are really solid on this side personally. Really heavy and will cause some problem. You keep in. I'm not saying anything about braking points, because these are all flat out if you have a good setup and if you can drive the car both on R5 cars and on WRC cars. You keep in and really early go on this right corner. It narrows quite a bit. There is a sumppu in Finnish, and there are no good words in English on that. But there is like that narrowing thing at the exit of the corner, and you don't want to slide on that, because then you can't make a good line for the next left corner. If you don't have a good setup, you can use a left foot braking when you are turning into this corner or and at this point where we are now. You can also turn through the car a little bit sideways on this right corner, because then when you are, let's say, here and you are sideways, you are already counter-steering to the left. Your front tires are pointing to the way you want to go now, and the slide of the sideways thing will end now, and you automatically have the right angle on your, of your front tires because of that counter-steering. Don't cut here, because there is the bank, but go again inside here, so you get a good line on this short right over crest. On some setups you can cut, but as you can see there is a bank inside, and most times it will be a problem, so don't cut here. I don't even think it will be a good thing on time-wise. It's good not to cut there. A short left-hander here, just took it inside, but again don't cut, there was the bank. A little bit of a straight. And now we got the braking point. It's not a proper braking, it's a little braking. If you are with the WRC car, you downshift to 5th gear. And if you are with R5 car and you have the good setup and you are a good driver and things like that, you don't have to downshift at all. But sometimes, like when you are racing and you want to, you don't want to take risks and things like that, it's good to downshift to fourth gear also on R5 car. Let's go rid of back so we can take the line. You want to cut as much as you can. Yes, there is the bank inside, but you need this cut. So this is a place where to take risks and win a little bit time if you want to. Cut as much as you can. So you can get a good line for the next corner, which is like a short right, which opens over this crest. Don't hit those white things again. They are bad. As bad as my clutch using skills at the moment. And the car will jump here quite a bit. And you will land on your left tires usually. That will make the car a little bit unstable. So be aware of that. I think I want to go a little bit back. I forgot something. Just good time also to practice with the new clutch pedal. Because there is one thing I want to tell you. Here at this point, I am a little bit of sideways and I have a counter steering to the right. Sometimes, when I have a little too much speed, I touch my brake, a little bit left foot braking here, so I will stop the slide, and as my counter steering is on the right, my right front tires are already on the right angle. So I stop my slide here, and I have my counter steering on the right, so the car will automatically go on this way. And even if you are not sideways, it's sometimes good to brake a little bit. Use a little bit of left foot braking for these jumps, because it's quite big, and as I said, you will land on your left tires, and it will make the car quite unstable. And now it seems a really easy place, but when you are going like 150 kilometers per hour, it's not. It's quite easy to land too much on here on the left, so you will be here then. And when you are here, it's quite easy to bounce off the tear. And there is those that tree next on me, and that tree where you are going to end up, and it will destroy your car. That's a really, or not a really tricky place, but you have to be, what is the word? What a precise while taking the lines and while, you know, setting the compressions on your suspension and things like that to make the car going good on over that jump. Then it's just a slight ride. And now when we are going over the crest, I have only one word. Keep in. Okay. Again, we have a positive camper inside of the road and negative camper outside of the road. So we don't want to like loop some racing line and go there. Because it's quite difficult to make the car to go over that camper change again. So just be here at the positive camper. Now the turn tightens a bit. So some cars that I know that will make it, I can a little bit take line. Like somewhere here. But not more left. Like middle of the road, you can take a little bit line. It will make this corner more easy. You can cut a bit, but don't hit those sticks that are pointing up. Come on. And don't hit those white signs. As you see, there was a rut, and there's a little bit of holes and all kind of things that will make your car unstable. So if you are not sure about your setup, it's more safe to go a little bit sideways over that tightens part of the corner and over those ruts and holes. Because if you are doing it with a straight car, it's quite easy to lose the grip on the front where you are hitting those ruts, and then you will understeer to somewhere here. And as you see, it's not the place where you want to go. But yeah. If you have a good setup, you don't have to brake at all on this on that long right corner. Not even when it tightens. if you don't have a good setup, or if you want, you can use a little bit of left foot braking before it tightens, or when you are going over those ruts and holes, it will make your car a little bit more stable. Then we have a short, like right left. Nothing special, just go as straight as you can. You can get a little bit here, but not too much. Then choose a right line, because there are holes on the left, and the next corner is on the left, so it's good to be here on the right. It's not a proper braking. Again, you just a little bit touch on your brakes. If you are on WC car, you downshift to fifth gear, and on R5 car, you keep it on fifth gear. And at this point, it's maybe good time to say that when I'm talking about those gears, I'm talking with the setup that has a long gearbox. Okay. Long gearbox settings. So you throw the car, you can be really sideways here if you want, because you don't have to get the like good exit speed. And it's good to keep in. So if you throw the car sideways, it helps you to keep in my, at least on my opinion. You can cut a little bit, but again, the grass is quite sticky, so it's easy to spin or easy to make the car turn too much, which will make the next right-hander difficult. You keep in, and again, on this point, you touch a little bit on the brakes, downshift one gear, you know, lower on WRC car, and now on R5 car, you also do the downshift from 5th gear to 4th gear. And if you are on the slide, if you are on sideways, you have now a counter steering to the right, and when you touch your brake, you will stop your sliding, and your front tires are already pointing on the right direction, so it is the direction where the car will go when you touch the brake and stop your slide. This is a really short corner, quite tight, but short and positive camper, and you can cut. There is that little ditch, but there is not a really big bank here after that ditch, so you can cut a lot if you want, and if the rules of your racing series allow you to cut. Remember that many times you are not allowed to cut with the wall car width. Wall car width, okay. But if you can, here is the place to do it. Again, for me, this is a good place to go sideways, because then somewhere here, you are like this position, you are sideways, and your tires are pointing to the left. Okay? So when you, again, touch the brake just a little bit, do a one downshift, both on R5 cars and WRC cars, and when you touch your brake and you have your counter steering to the left, your front tires are already pointing to the direction where you want to steer your car. So simple. So it's a little bit like a three-step dancing what you do on those corners. First you brake a little bit, through the car to the left, brake a little bit to, again, through the car on right, and here brake a little bit again and throw your car to the left. It's quite a good feeling when you get it right. And it's really good almost in every car, with all four-wheel drive cars, all rear-wheel drive cars, not maybe on front-wheel drive cars. But with many cars you can get a good feeling on this section. This is again a positive camper a little bit, and you can you can use this cut. There is not too much space, but a little bit, and it's just enough to use that sticky grass to suck your car a little bit, so you can go like a little bit too fast on this corner, because this sucking grass will, you know, little bit reduce your speed and keep your in this corner, so you are not going to slide off. If you go sideways this corner, be sure you go out with straight car, because you are going to need that exit speed, because now we have a long straight. Some bumps here, and that last is basically a jump, a little jump, and if you have a bad setup, it will give you a big kick on the rear, so it will make the car a little bit unstable. Then is a really tricky part, or tricky braking. it's really hard to remember where to start the braking. It is. I think if we start the braking now, we are late. But you will see the point, braking point on the replay I'm going to show after this. And of course you want to be here on the right, because the corner is on the left. But here is a little bit like a little short right corner. So if you do the braking like that, that your right tire are off the road, it will be almost impossible to turn in. So you want to be on the right side, but not too much. Then we have it's basically a 90 left, at least on my notes, with a positive camper. But as we are on the downhill now, which is the reason why this braking is so difficult, the downhill will stop, or the downhill will end here, or at least it's not so steep anymore. So it will, the ending of the downhill and the positive camper, especially if you are cutting on the ditch, all those things will make a little bit like a dip or bump here, and the bump will break your grip. So the exit of this corner is quite slippery, and it's easy to slide here, where we have a little bit of negative road camper, so it's very easy to end up here, hitting out that sign. And to avoid that, for me, it's at least more safe to go a little bit sideways. So when you are exit of this corner and you're a little bit sideways, you can just make your steering wheel straight and your tires will pull off your car on this point. Because if you do that corner on straight car and you end up here, understeering here, it's really difficult to save the situation anymore. And what else? Oh, the gears. For R5 cars, it's 3 gear corner, and I would say 4th gear on WRC. I can't remember, but I think it's 4th gear. No reason to change to 3rd gear. Let's see if we can go away on this ditch. Yep. Okay, then this, I think on my note it's a 3 right over crest. Something like medium right over crest. You took the line again here on the left, and before the corner you turn in, because again if you turn, sorry, after the crest you turn in, because if you turn before, sorry, now I'm messing with my words. Okay, before the crest turn in, because if you turn after the crest, again your tires are not under the load of the car and there will be no grip. So before the crest turn in, there's no need to brake, and you can cut like this, but be sure that both of your tires, like the left tires, will not go to the ditch, because if your both tires, right and left tires, go on the ditch, it's really easy to roll the car. You know, you are jumping a little bit sideways, and if the left of, if your left tires hit to this ditch after that little jump or that little lightening that the crest will do, it's really easy to roll. So only right tires on this ditch. And then this is a tricky part. Be right here, brake a little bit before the crest ends, because again you want to turn in early enough. Brake a little bit. You don't have to do any downshifts, but do a little bit left foot braking at least, where you, when you are taking that right line, right side line, and turn quite early here, and try to make your tires to hit your right tires on that rod. It is a really difficult, a really narrow place, because you don't want to hit also on those white signs. So there is a little, just a little pace. But if you can do it, you will be a really fast through this corner. Another option which I like to do when I'm doing a race where I don't want to take so much risks is to go here, Now we are on a negative road camper, and you can see there is also loose gravel, so it's quite slippy. But if you manage to put your left tire on this rut, it will give you the grip you need, so you don't have to like care about that negative camper and that low grip, loose gravel. It will upset your car a little bit, but be, you know, there is space. You can use the space, so it's not so dangerous if the car comes a little unstable when hitting that rod. It depends a lot how you are driving it and how which car you have and which setup you have, that how the rod affects. Sometimes you can do it like there is no rod at all, and sometimes it will cause a real lot of problems. Then we have, I think it's on my note, short 5 left over crest. So we choose the left line here, and we keep in because the next junction will be to the right. And somewhere here, you start the braking. It's quite difficult braking again, as you don't have any reference point where to start it. Keep the left line here, and you can use a little bit of grass. You can destroy this, I don't know what this is in English, that orange thing. You can destroy it, so you make this corner a little bit, or you can take a little bit better line if you destroy it. This is second gear, both R5 and WRC cars. You can cut a little bit, but don't hit those signs again. They are really heavy and solid on Richard Burns. And there is a little bit of positive road camper at the apex of this corner, but it's really hard to make your whole car to fit in. Usually your rear tires are not on this positive camper. A good exit is needed, because we have again a long straight. Slight left and slight right, nothing special. Then we have this short right over crest, you can cut a little bit. And keep in, so you get a good line on this next left corner. Be really early in, cut a little bit, because the car will jump here, and if you are not early in, and if you are not cutting, you don't have to brake. But if you are not doing those things, you will jump straight on this. And again, it is as fast as my clutch skills at the moment. Then this little slight right, use the cut. And now you have to brake quite a lot. You can cut this also quite a lot if you want. And all the braking you are doing it for this corner, because after this corner there is a long straight, so you want to go slow in and fast out. And it's a fourth gear corner for both R5 and WRC cars. And there is no room to cut. Of course you can cut here, but it's no point because it's such a long corner. So if you cut here, you are on wrong line. And again, you have a little bit positive road camper, so basically nothing special, just don't cut and get a good exit. It's quite for some reason it's really easy for me to throw the car sideways there. I want to do it, even I know it's slow, but I want to do it. So if you really want to do a good time, be sure you are not too sideways. Then there is some holes, they will make the car a little bit unstable, but nothing special, flat out through them. And now be early in, again with the, because of the road camper things. You can use a little bit of the ditch, but it's not no needed, and it will make the car quite unstable. Just a little bit, don't go like here bottom of the ditch. Be here on the edge of the road. This tightens a little bit before crest, and go off the cut before this crest, because there is a... Well, there's a little bit like a bump, and you will roll if you cut through this crest. The corner opens over this crest, so it's quite easy, basically. Just be sure that you are, when you jump over that crest, you are not doing counter steering. Even if you are jumping sideways, do not do counter steering to the right, because then when you land, your car will be here, and then it's quite the difficult to turn in anymore, because you will have this crest here. So be here in of the corner, and this is also a flat out, if you have this good line. Then we have a crest, depends on the car, on the grip, and the setup on the driver, if you want to brake on top of this crest or after it. But at least somewhere here you have to brake. Again, but this is a really steep downhill, so it's difficult braking. Be around the left. Now you don't want to be here on the ditch, because it's quite steep, the edge of the ditch and road, so it will make the turn in quite difficult. So don't go there, just be here. All tires on the gravel. And nothing, basically nothing special. There is a room to cut, but don't cut too much. I can show you why. There is a quite a big like negative road camper if you go here over this. And if you have, when you have this rocket negative camper, it will make the junction quite slippery. And I think it's not a good thing. Like, don't, you can cut a little bit, but don't cut too much. And don't go too early in. It's quite easy to go early in, because there is the room inside of the corner, but or that base in space, I don't know what's the correct word, inside of the corner, but don't go too early in, and don't go too early on gas, on throttle, because it's quite easy to go too early on the throttle on this corner, and then the car will understeer a lot. So go back to the throttle after the apex of this junction. And for both R5 and WRC cars, it is a second gear place. Second gear corner. Okay. Then there is a bump or dip or whatever, flat out. Slight right tightens a little bit, and is important, or not really important, but good to keep in. And also keep right over this little crest, so you can get a good line to this left corner. It's a little bit tighter, but we have a positive road camper, so no need to brakes. But now, immediately after that corner, you want to brake, because now there is a little hole or dip which will break your braking grip. So you want to be early on the brakes. And then we have a crest that dips quite a bit, which is of course bad for your braking grip. So you want to be already on the correct speed before you jump. And you also want to turn in again before you jump and before you lose the load of your wheels. But it's a long corner that tightens, so don't turn in too early. The apex of the corner is it's somewhere like here. Here is the point where you want to really go in, at least in my opinion. And as you seen, there is a lot of that loose gravel, so it's really slippery. And that dip before the corner will make your suspension to go really low, which will also make a little bit negative effect to your grip. Especially if you have bad setup, it will bottoming out a lot of that dip and that corner. So there is a little grip. But yeah, on my driving style, it's good to, you know, set the car sideways, which also helps to hit the apex, hit the late apex. So basically I'm sideways at the beginning of the corner, and here the slide ends, and my car is on this position. Or I hope it's not always like that. Keep in, and then we have, I think this two left tightens too narrow on my notes. It's like something like half long maybe on for many peoples. There's a little bit positive road camper again, but no room to cut. But you need to keep in, because the road narrows here. There's a little bit of sumpu again, and there is that sign you don't want to hit. Then it's quite a slight left, little bit of bumps. Just be sure that you turn enough because of those bumps. But don't cut and don't go sideways, it's so slight corner that no reason to go sideways and kill your speed. Then we have water here, and it's quite deep, so it will upset your car, and because of that, and because of one another thing I'm going to tell you, you want to brake already here. So you like start the braking here, lift your pedal, brake pedal here, and continue the braking here. And it is also because if you are braking when you are going over the water, the front of your car will be really low and it will cause some problem. So it's good to release the brake pedal a little bit. It's really easy to lock your brakes also, because it will make the car, like it will unbalance the car when you go over that water, so you can't make a really heavy braking here. And this is a normal 90 ride. A little positive road camber again, a little bit of loose gravel, not especially slippy. Maybe a little bit of cut, but somehow it's not good to cut a lot of here. Then keep it all over crest and you will finish the stage. You can brake a little bit now, because we are already in the finish and there is a corner. Don't go too early in, because this corner tightens a bit, and if you go too early in and you are not braked enough, you will end up here hitting on this. And believe me, it's really solid and stiff. So don't go too early on that after finish left-hander. But here it was. I hope I was clear enough. And let's next see the how I do the stage fast. Oh, I'm not sure if it's fast, but faster than this, I promise.
2, 1, go, 4 left.
Okay, this wasn't perfect run, but I don't have the time to do a perfect run, but this will do the job. Okay, you see that I'm quite wide here, but I go a little bit back to the road to avoid that little tree that is a really solid. And then I go back to inside. Okay? Now back to inside.
Right, in, don't cut, and double caution. For right over crest. 40, mighty left, bump, cut,
braking and right line after the crest.
Extra long, 40.
I missed a little bit of that junction. It would have been better to turn in a little bit earlier and be on the crest a little bit longer. Now, it was a little bit too late turning in, and there is like a little bit too much energy that is pulling me off the road, that is pulling me straight. If I would have been earlier on the grass, if I would have spent more time on the grass with the half throttle, there would have been now on this position more energy that is pulling me like forward instead of energy that is pulling me off the road sideways.
Short 6 right, give in, 40, caution, keep right to the crest, into 4 left, tightens, give in, and early 3 right, tightens, to narrow, into short 3 left, 5 left, and short 4 right to the crest, and short 4 left, double caution, short
2
left, into short 2 right to the crest, don't cut, give in, and short 4 left, into 6 right, tightens, into caution, 4 right over crest, opens, double tightens,
now just keep
80,
in.
Early short 4 right, 4 left to narrow, 120. Double caution, late 2 left, give in, into 5 left, 5.
And now, remember, it wasn't so easy with the R5 car, as these are so powerless, with quite good grip, but it was possible. So you brake a little bit, throw the car sideways, brake a little bit, do a downshift, through the car, throw the car sideways, and third time, brake a little bit, do downshift and throw the car sideways. It's like bum, bum, bum. Dancing and braking and sliding with the car.
Into short 90 right,
like
cut, give
bump,
in, and 90 left, cross,
and
250.
Bum, and bum. So nice.
Keep it over crest, jump 150. Double caution, short 90 left, bump 80. 3 right
to the crest, 40. Okay, I don't know why. I think that I told you that use the third gear, but I used fourth gear, so yeah, third or fourth gear, and for some reason, just when I told to do so, I didn't, so I did the corner with the straight car. But it's more safety to be a little bit sideways at the exit of the corner.
Keep right to the crest, into caution, three left tightens, to narrow, don't cut, bump, and don't
now
short,
left
four left,
braking.
To 13, short, five
like
left,
that.
Over
and
crest,
use the base
double
here.
Caution, 17, 90 right, to narrow, don't cut, 13, short, five left, and early short, five right, 100, short, five right, over crest, jump, 60, caution, short, three left, over crest, slight cut, 30, short, six right, double caution, and short, two left, cut, give in, and two right, long, 150.
Early five. There you have to be, I don't know the word, pace, patient, something like that, you know, you have to keep calm and do not go sideways. Just wait, keep the car straight, and that will give you the best exit speed for the following fast section.
Spider, Dr. Crest. And four left.
And then just
over
keep
crest.
In.
30.
No, no counter steering here.
Double caution.
And again keep
18.
In.
What right? 60.
Then a tricky break.
And five right from Titans. 40.
And I went just a little bit too early inside. And you see what happens. Immediately after I hit the apex, there comes a huge understeering. I didn't have too much speed, so it wasn't a problem, but not like that. Little bit later into the corner and there will not be any understeering at all.
Keep right over crest, and three left plus, over, give in, double caution, 80, keep middle to the crest, into three right, tightens, long, baby,
early.
And two left, tightens, long, six right, and three left, bump, 50, double caution, caution, and 90
and
right,
then early
and keep middle
before
over
the
crest,
water.
70, two left, over crest.
I brake a little bit too much on there. Yeah, I think maybe it was good that I did some mistakes on that replay run, because it just shows that it's easy to tell how to do it, but it's not easy to do it, even if I have done this stage like 10,000 times. You know, don't be a disappointment if you don't get it right every time. It's not easy. Not at all. But yeah, I think that the lesson is over now. Thank you, see you on next time. And if you have some hopes that which states you would like to see, put it on the comments, okay? I'm not sure if I can do a proper video on every state, because I don't know every stage as well as I know this, but if there on the comments is some stage that I know really well, I can do the video. And I don't know when I'm going to do the next video. I'm doing this when I have time and when I have the correct feeling. I'm not going to take any stress about it, just to keep this fun and just to maintain the good feeling. So let's see. But yeah, thanks a lot and see you.